Hey, Don here. Okay, what mic are we on? Okay, I got it right. Yeah, I'm on the SM58, and the Wi-Fi mic is working. Let's turn that on. Okay, it was working. Yeah. No. Why am I getting something on the desktop but not on the... I don't know. Never seen that happen before. I just installed the... Let's go ahead and go back to normal.
Okay. I may be having an echo, though, huh? Because I don't think I'm supposed to see my mic coming in on the desktop. That usually means you're getting an echo. I'm going to listen to it for a second and see. I'll turn it on advanced properties, and this is one of the only things I'm trying to get. See, I just installed OBS Studio on my Dell server, my HP DL, that's what made me say Dell, HP DL 380 G7 server that I'm using as my main desktop machine. I'm looking at my, and I'm looking way up because now I have a 49-inch 4K TV as my monitor, testing. So, you know, I've got my 4K camera sitting over there, and I can see that it looks really grainy. Of course, it's not set. It's over going over the USB to the server. So the most it can do is like 12. Let me get on the... Let's see, Camform desktop. Okay, now that does somewhat work, but the desktop, too much of it's cut off. That's the thing. Too much of it's cut off. Because, you know, if I set my palette to 1080p like I always have with my other machine, and that's what size my resolution was on my monitor, you know, that's what I was using. But when I set it to 1080p, then everything still must fit fairly well. See, some of these, like the 4K camera's wider, you can see those blue lines that come up. I just had to, you know, painstakingly set everything to fit. Now, if I set it to, I don't think I can change it while I'm recording. If I do, it might break it, so. But if I set, I don't know what made my, it's been working, my Audio Cam 3 has been working, and I just muted it, and you can't see what I'm doing on the desktop this way. Let's see if, I don't think the desktop fits this way either. Yeah, see, it's even, that's how much is missing. You're seeing a little bit of that feedback you always get when you show the desktop, and I'm looking at it in the OBS interface. But you see how, excuse me, how big the text is. And if I switch it to my palette, my OBS palette, to the same as my desktop resolution, then it gets small, but you can at least see all of whatever's in there. Like some of this is out of the Cam 1. That is fitting just right. I just set it up there. I didn't have a good place to set it. Just trying to test things. And Cam 4 is just right. Now if I, and my titles are just right. They're all like they should be. But, when I set, I forgot to check about that reverb, or I think there's a terrible, I haven't listened, so I'm afraid there's a terrible, you're not going to be able to see it no matter what I do, are you? Let's go back to, on Endoscope Works, I'll just show how things look with it set at 1080p, 1080p palette, 1080p output. You can change, you can have a different output than your palette, and I usually just always had it 1080, but since the monitor is a different size, that's just something I have setting under the Endoscope to see how it looks. And let's just go through everything. Okay, this is the intro text, music with it. And this desktop, you know, the resolution's too big to fit in the 1080. Cam 1, that fits just right inside the 1080 palette. 1 and 4, that's how You know, that's how all of my double screens used to fit. I had them set up like the 1080 camera was, the 4K camera, it's doesn't look as grainy. Let's see, which one is it? Oh, it's that one. Okay, it's just because it's small, I think, and it was, you know, it's, I've got it sized down to fit alongside the other one. I can kind of tell, though, that it's still a little grainy. I think maybe I can make that better in the camera. I figured out that, how to get into the resolution settings and change them. And I changed it all the way up to the 48 megapixels that it can do with the upscaling, you know, but it doesn't look good. I didn't realize what it was looking like because I was, you know, I was only using the camera by itself with its little bitty preview. And I had it on, I was moving around and moving the camera around, so I had it on 48 megapixels and on motion. I finally found also in that same area the motion settings, you know. I don't know if it's just I've got the motion and the 48 megapixel, and I haven't experimented with it. I haven't done any more recording since a couple months or so ago. And I know that's active when you go USB. You only get two choices. It's even less than 1080. The biggest one's less than 1080. It's like, I'd have to look at it. I don't remember it. It's one step down from 1080 or two steps down, and then they're even smaller than that resolution. So that's another reason why it would look more grainy, because it's not. But it is a 13 megapixel CMOS sensor in the camera, but it actually looks, the best video I've made, I had it set on 4K, but it was, well, when I got in there and I figured out where you go to change the resolution, it was set on 11 megapixels, and it's a 13 megapixel CMOS sensor. And I was outside, you had lots of good light. Just got lucky that I was where I was at. It was good lighting. And it looked really good. It's the first time I've ever seen that thing make a good, really good looking video. And even the colors look good. And so now I think, hopefully I can at least set it on like 13 megapixel or maybe 12 or something just under, because you know, it's supposedly a Sony sensor, so I would think it could do 13 megapixels, but then again, you know, nothing does exactly what it says it will, you know. So I could set it on 12. It was on 11, or I set it on 11, but I want as much, you know, as I can get. I was thinking about setting it on 13, see what it looks like, and then set it on 12, and then maybe go back to 11. And then the motion, can't think of the right word, you know, to try to make it look when you move the camera to look better. But you know, like there's some of it, the only ones that really work good is the I've been watching a lot of videos from a guy named Marcus Pix on YouTube. His name is Marcus. He calls his channel Marcus Pix. He's a very, really experienced, you know. He used to work in Hollywood. He wasn't a cameraman in Hollywood. He was actually an artist and stuff, but anyway, he did actually make a feature film himself. I mean, he learned how to do all this stuff over the years. He's younger than me, but he said how old he was. He said, I'm 64, and he's about 8 or 10 years younger than me. But anyway, I haven't watched it yet. I think I've seen that movie. He said, you may run across it. He did a video on, like, people keep asking him, you know how they do. They ask, what about this? What about that? How are you? Who are you? What are you? Where'd you come from? You know, so finally made a whole video on it. And I don't read the comments a whole lot, so I didn't really know that until he made the video. But I was curious myself. He didn't really want to go into his history. I do that all the time. But sometimes I say the same thing over and over without, you know, not really realizing it. But anyway, he made a movie that I think I had actually recently seen in the list of movies that could be watched, like on YouTube, I think. And it's on YouTube, I'm pretty sure. And I'll have to go ahead and watch it. He showed a clip of it, so I'll have an idea. It was, he's very, very good. I mean, he did it for Hollywood movies. He made miniatures, he made a pirate movie himself, and he did a lot of camera work and stuff, and, you know, hanging out of it. This was back in the 90s, so the cameras were big, and, of course, they're always very expensive, but he was showed clips of him hanging out of a helicopter shooting some of the action scenes and stuff. And anyway, with explosions and all that, he said he likes to do that stuff. And, but with the people, you know, you got to like when you have people in there, you can't use the miniatures. But then, yeah, anyway, it's really involved, but... and I don't know, you know, I've never done that. I don't know all the details on how to do it, but anyway, he blew up the miniatures. He didn't blow up anything big, and then, but he makes them look real. He likes to make them, and he was so good at it. He did a bunch of, he named off a few movies he made miniatures for, and then, he named off a whole bunch of movies that he had done the artwork for, like maybe the, I can't remember. I think he made a lot of the artwork for the posters, you know, that they'd put in the movie theaters. And I think he did some of the, I don't know if he did the, I don't think he's really into, like, he didn't do CGI title work and junk like that. He was not into that stuff. He knows computers really well enough, I'm sure, because he makes videos and all that stuff. But, yeah, he didn't mention that. So anyway, what was my point? I completely forgot. Okay, there's cam one and two, but two's not on. It's just not on. So anytime I go to, and then one in desktop, and see, that's, you're seeing me over there because I'm showing the preview. I guess I could change it. I hadn't thought about that. Why didn't I do that? Okay, so I'll just go around to the different parts of my desktop and see what those look like. I mean, I know they're going to be cut off. And then, let's see, where is desktop? I'll do that. So here's what my desktop would look like on the other programs. I can't see without staying on the preview what it's going to look like, but I can look back at my test video. And I forgot where I was. Let's go back down through. Oh, that's where I was, I think. Two. It's not there. Two and four. See, that's how wide camera four really is. And what I do is I let the other, when there's another camera beside it, like one and four, one's not, what happened to one? Now it's not working? Dadgummit, now it's working. Sometimes they do that. I was hoping, that's why I didn't turn on two, because I know I have too much on my phone cameras, one, two, they're going over the Wi-Fi, and my Wi-Fi mic, it's not working right now. My Wi-Fi is it. I didn't turn on the other camera too because I wanted to not overwhelm the Wi-Fi because I have 2 5-megapixel security cameras running all the time. Let's see, and I did reboot my modem and my router earlier this evening too. So I would expect all that to be okay. It's just acting up. Well, it could be. No, I don't have anything set up. I thought about setting things up to higher resolution because this server can handle it, but I didn't change the camera, the phone camera, I didn't change any of the camera's resolution. But, so that's 2 and 4. 2's not on, okay, 2 in desktop. 4, see that's 4 fitting the 1080p screen. I think maybe some of it's probably cut off. Let's see. No, I guess it's not. Then foreign desktop. Now let's go ahead and move around the desktop and see. And in the scope. Okay, I was afraid you froze up for a minute there. Everything's gotten to be a little bit of a delay already. That's what it is, I think. It's not showing it as quick as I'm getting over there. And then that's one, and you know, the one's going away in some of my scenes. It may be because I've got that palette set so big. I bet it is. Yeah. So, no, wait. I think it's on 1080. It's on 1080. It's not set too big.
That would, you know, the more data you give it to do, the one and four, where's one in desktop? Now there's one in desktop, but one doesn't always come in now. After I've been there it is now. But it's frozen. It came in, but it's frozen. If I get back on the desktop for a bit, sometimes it'll, my stuff will come back. Let's see. Sometimes. I'm not sure why. That doesn't make any sense, because the machine I've been streaming on for all these several years is, could be, well, I imported my settings from, from what I use on the other machine, and I noticed, I went through it all, and I kind of noticed some differences. Now, that's desktop again, but you won't be able to see what I'm doing, except for the top left of the screen, a very small portion of it, I can tell that. This portion right up in here. I forgot what it was I wanted to show now. Oh, I was going to look at my... Okay, the memory, yeah, it's using more memory than usual. 1.3 gigabyte. And, oh, it is using 7%. Now, let's look at the... Yeah, it's registering on the... But see, I've got 2 6-core processors in this server. It's working it. More than it ever did on my Lenovo i5, as I call it, is a quad core with 4 gig RAM. And it can do it on these settings. Unless I change something that I don't remember. I may have changed the palette off of 1080. I can't remember now to look. No, I think it's on 1080. That's why things are too big. That's why the resolution is too big to fit in the palette of the video. And Ethernet's working pretty good. Let's see, I'm using 4.8 gig of RAM, but I've got 62.9 gigabyte of RAM, usable RAM, is 64 gig of RAM, and I've got 2 6-core processors with temperature threading at 64 cores. I mean, they're not any one of them. I can hear it working, but it's not overwhelmed. Oh, there's the list of the cores right there when you do that. Let's see if I can get a screenshot of it like that. It didn't work. Not quite sure what, where you put the mouse to make it do that. Just kind of does it when it wants to. Well, this makes it, looking at that graph makes it work hard, lot noticeably harder. The fans will ramp up pretty soon after you get over there. I still want to, well, you can't see anything I'm doing, so there's no point in. But the only one that actually works good is 1 and 4, but 1's not working again. So, there it is. It took it a minute to come in. Okay, I'll leave it there for now. Now, oh wait, no, let's just go to, I'm going to get on the desktop, or maybe I shouldn't, I'll probably break the video. Let me just get out of this video, and I'm going to change the settings and start another test. This is what I'll do, the music out. And after the music out, I'll go, generally go silent, and then I stop.